right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios, and welcome in Keith Schaefer. He's an independent analyst with the Oil and Gas Investment Bulletin. Keith, good to have you back. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Steve.
We thought you'd be perfect to talk about the announcement today, a $40 billion mega project for LNG, leaving British Columbia, heading over to Asia. It's the biggest mega project in Canadian history. You hinted at this a few months ago when we chatted, that preliminary work was already being done in and around that area in preparation for what happened today, and that's the big announcement. So not a big surprise to you?
No. This was the worst kept secret in Canadian energy. Like I said a few months ago, they had all these huge trucks with the wrapping still on the tires and everything. So it was they had broadcast it pretty loud that this was going to go ahead. They had to kind of put the brakes on officially, but on the ground, everything has been a go for quite a while.
And they obviously had a feeling this deal was going to come. They wanted to be in preparation because it's going to take a lot of years to build this project. They're hoping it comes online in 2024. So the quicker they can get to it, the better it is, I would think.
Oh, yes. So it takes a huge amount of prep work. And honestly, when you think, Steve, that with our First Nations consultations, all the environmental laws we have, this is the biggest checklist all these international companies ever have anywhere in the world. So it takes a lot of, you know, dotting the I's, crossing the T's mm-hmm. to get everything ready. And now that it is ready, I think we're going to see some fantastic movement in getting this thing going as fast as possible.
So I mentioned $40 billion is the entire project. So what does this mean for British Columbians and Canadians?
Oh, well, certainly for everyone in rural Western Canada, it means a huge new job source. They're talking about 10,000 construction jobs. And with Fort Mac and oil prices not being the same what it was a few years ago,
right,
this is going to be a new economic engine for rural Western Canada. So that's going to be, I think, a huge deal. You're going to see, just like you did before, where planes would go nonstop from St. John's, Newfoundland to Fort Mac, you're going to see all these new routes, new people coming into the West Coast to work here.
Yeah, and it's going to be based in Kitimat, and it's seeing a bit of a boom right now in Kitimat, real estate-wise, as you can imagine, and will only continue. I mean, Kitimat is about to put themselves on the map around the world.
Oh, yes. Literally, since the town was built when Alcan was there 50 years ago, they've never seen anything like this. So we are going to see massive new infrastructure around the town, as well as just on the docks at the site itself, for sure.
So with the investment that's happening, and we'll talk about the consortium in just a second, but for the investment that's happening now on LNG in British Columbia, will there be a ripple effect for improving the conditions of the gold miners or copper miners or silver? Is there a ripple effect coming off of the investment that we're seeing in BC?
Yes, actually, there should be two, really. I think you're going to see one kind of negative in that service costs are probably going to go higher. So all the guys that supply pipe and all kinds of ancillary services for the building and maintenance of these mines are now going to have another market, a huge market that has a lot of money. So they'll probably see service costs go up. But I think another big thing that we should see is that, you know, we saw NAFTA get done this week. Oil has had a big run. Now the LNG announcement. Those are all big, big things in a very short span. So I expect to see the Canadian dollar rise. Mm-hmm. I would expect that all the international money flow that has really seen Canada as a backwater and really been kind of anti-Canada with all our pipeline issues and not that being able to get resolved. Now they've got three big news points that say, yes, you can invest in Canada. So I would expect a lot of international money to come back into Canada, and the miners are absolutely going to see some of that.
So I mentioned the companies, PETRONAS, PetroChina, KOGAS, which is Korean Gas, and Mitsubishi are the companies involved in this consortium, and they'll be coming in. Big names, big money coming in. Is this the first of just maybe more of these kind of companies coming in? We have an abundance of LNG in British Columbia, so one plant will be good, but more is even better.
I think the market actually truly does expect two, if not three, in the next 5-7 years. So when Australia had its big run in the last decade, there ended up being three massive LNG plants side by side built at the same time in northern Australia. Mm. So the street is now expecting both Chevron and Exxon to announce positive FIDs, probably not very quickly. I think they're going to give Shell a couple of years to really get going, because nobody wants to see huge labor explosions. Most of the LNG facilities in Australia, for example, ended up being so much over cost, those guys are never going to make money. But as you said, we have an abundance of LNG, got a workforce who would love to get at it. And so it just makes sense that both Exxon and Chevron have spent a lot of money already. They could easily follow in the footsteps of what Shell is doing with their group.
Why now? What is it that changed from when we heard about LNG happening and it was canceled to now? What's changed?
One word, China. Mm. They have increased their LNG imports by 30% per year. In fact, I think last year was 50%. This year, it's closer to 30%, obviously off a much bigger base. They have shown the world they are very committed to improving their environment. They want to get off the dirty brown coal. So the high-quality coal they're importing is actually staying steady. And they have LNG prices internationally have just gone from about $6 an MCF to 10, even a hair over 10.
Wow.
So the majors see that China is absolutely committed to getting their pollution down. LNG is the main way they're going to do that. And that's why you're seeing Canada now being able to jump on that bandwagon with a group like Shell.
It's going to be incredible as it continues to go on over the next few years to cover this story. A brand new industry in British Columbia, and as I mentioned, $40 billion, the biggest mega project in Canadian history. It's incredible. Keith, thanks for the insight. Sure appreciate it.
Thanks for having me, Steve.
All right, Keith Schaefer with the Oil and Gas Investment Bulletin here in Proactive in Vancouver.